Hello everyone, and welcome to a new ibmi RPG and SQL sample video. It is usual that in a table we have fields where the stored value is repeated many times. For example, for a customer table we can have the zip code or the country or perhaps a type or a key repeated many times. And it is also very normal to group the results to obtain the number of rows that have that value. For example, how many customers are from a specific country or have a specific key. But sometimes we need not to get how many customers are from a country, but the list of customers who are from a country, but in a single field. Today, I'm gonna show you an example of how to do this. Let's go. First of all, let me show you the data we are gonna play with. I have a few example tables. One of them is the table games. Let me show you its content. As you can see, a game has its ID, its name, a type, and then a developer ID, a distributor ID, and a designer ID. Of course, there is a table of designers, a table of developers, and a table of distributors. Well, imagine that I want to get which games are from distributor number 11, which are from number 12, and which are from number 14. But we want that result in just three rows. How can we do it? Well, for example, we can obtain a list of distributors and the game they correspond to. Let me write from Well, but this is not what we want. We want it grouped. But if we use group by, what we can obtain is this. Okay, so for distributor number 11, I have one game. For number 12, I have one game. And for number 14, I have two games, as we can see in the first select. Okay, so we have these two games, 52 and 54, for the distributor number 14. Well, to obtain the information as we want it, we are going to use the listagg function. The listagg function aggregates a set of string elements into one string by concatenating the strings. And we also can use a separator to put between every two different strings. So, with listagg, we can, for example, do something like this. Select and if I run it, well, as you can see, in this case I'm getting three rows, okay? And for this row, that is the distributor number 14, I'm getting the two games separated by a comma, okay? So this way I'm getting the distributor ID, a list of games, in this case, that is named games, separated by a comma. The information that I'm getting is the ID, and it is grouping, ordering by ID in ascending. Okay, we can change it for desk. Okay, and it is now descending. And also we can change the separator. We can, for example, use a colon. Okay, or a space simple. Okay, it's as simple as this. It is important to say that we need to use list AGG using within group and with an order. And this order can be ascending or descending, as I said before. Well, of course, we can improve the select to get more information. Let me, for example, let me get the distributor name, for example. Okay. Well, we're going to join two tables in this case. G, and this is going to have G here. And I'm going to get the name on is equal to there's something wrong. Oh, sorry, I forgot to include this in the group by. Okay, and as you see, this way I'm getting the name. Okay, well, of course, we can use this in an RPG program. Okay, so let me show you an example that I have made. It's this one. Well, as you can see, it is a very simple program. Okay, it is doing the same as I did before. It is fetching the results of the SQL statement execution into a data structure, and after that I'm displaying the information, sending it to my job log. Okay, of course, if you want, you can read every field of this structure, and you can use split, for example, to separate again the different values that are inside the field separated by a comma. Okay, well, this is only an example. Well, let me execute the program. Let me first of all, let me compile it. I want it to run. Okay, and now let me execute it, because I want to show you how it works. Okay, so if I run the program, if I see my job log, what I have is the same as in the run SQL scripts utility. Okay, so it works correctly. Well, as you can see, this is a very interesting way that we can use to group the results of our queries, and sometimes it will surely be very useful to us. As always, I hope you liked the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and as always, thanks for watching.